हेलो, आई एम डॉक्टर सतीश कुमार काशी, प्रोफेसर इन सिविल इंजीनियरिंग, वालचंद इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ टेक्नोलॉजी, सोलापुर। आई एम प्रेजेंटिंग अ टॉपिक, रिवर बेसिन्स एंड डैम्स ऑफ इंडिया। लर्निंग आउटकम्स ऑफ दिस सेशन, एट द एंड ऑफ दिस सेशन द स्टूडेंट्स विल बी एबल टू एनलिस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट रिवर्स ऑफ इंडिया एंड टेल अबाउट द वाटर रिसोर्सेज पोटेंशियल अवेलेबल इन दीज रिवर्स। द स्टूडेंट्स विल बी एबल टू लिस्ट important dams of India and list their salient features. The students will be able to explain the significance of dams and reservoirs in development of India. So this is a 3D map of India. So these are Himalayas, these are the northern plains, this is the Deccan Plateau. Here we find the Vindhya Parbat as well as Satpuras. Here these are the western ghats, these are the eastern ghats. And depending upon the geography, depending upon the slope of the continent, you will find that the rivers flow. Now, this is a typical watershed. So, you will find that in this particular watershed, this is a ridge line. So, depending upon the geography which I have shown and the mountains, you will find that India is divided into number of river basins. So this is the Ganga river basin, this is the Narmada river basin, this is the Mahanadi river basin, this is the Godavari river basin, this is Krishna river basin, this is Pennar river basin, this is Kaveri river basin, this is Vaigai river basin, whereas this is a Brahmaputra river basin. So here you will find that large areas of North India are covered by Ganga basin as well as the Brahmaputra basin, and these two rivers carry tremendous amount of water. Now, this particular figure gives us idea about the annual water potential in billion cubic meter available in different river basins. So, the Ganga river basin has say 525 billion cubic meter of potential, Brahmaputra has 537, Narmada just 45, Godavari 110, Mahanadi 68, Krishna 78, Mahi 11, Barak 48, Pennar 6.32, Sabarmati just 3.81, Suvarnarekha 12.37, Tapi 14, Kaveri 21, Indus 73. So there is a large variation from Ganga up to say 525 billion cubic meter to say Sabarmati to just 3 billion cubic meter. So this variation makes us also necessary to transfer the water from one basin to another basin, but that is not the purpose of this session, but rather to give the idea of the water resources potential with different rivers. This session is there. Now, the same figures are shown in graphical form. In Brahmaputra, it is 537, but as a small portion of Brahmaputra river comes in India, that's why utilizable is just 24, and so on. Now, the same figures are given in the tabular form. So, name of river basin, average annual potential in the river, estimated utilizable flow excluding groundwater. So, ultimately we come to these figures of total average annual potential in Indian rivers is 1869 billion cubic meter, and out of that utilizable potential is 690. Okay. So, from the hydrological point of view, these are some figures. Average annual precipitation is 4000 billion cubic meters over India, whereas average precipitation during monsoon months from say June to September, we receive about 3000 billion cubic meter. It means this is the major part of year, about 3/4 water we receive from rainfall. So, natural runoff comes out to be 1986 billion cubic meter, and estimated utilizable surface water resources are 690 billion cubic meter, as we discussed. Now, contribution of groundwater is equally important. So, वी कैन हार्नेस अबाउट 433 बिलियन क्यूबिक मीटर ऑफ वाटर फ्रॉम अ ग्राउंड वाटर रिसोर्सेस. सो अल्टीमेटली द पर कैपिटा वाटर अवेलेबिलिटी इन इंडिया कम्स आउट टू बी 1720 क्यूबिक मीटर पर ईयर. नाउ आई जस्ट गिव यू द पिक्टोरियल रिप्रेजेंटेशन ऑफ आवर डिफरेंट रिवर्स टू हैव द आइडिया अबाउट अवेलेबिलिटी ऑफ वाटर इन रिवर्स. सो रिवर गंगा ओरिजिनेट्स एट गंगोत्री. सो दिस इज अ फोटोग्राफ ऑफ गंगोत्री. दिस इज रिवर गंगा एट हरिद्वार व्हेन इट कम्स एट द फुट हिल्स. नाउ दिस इज रिवर गंगा एट वाराणसी. नाउ सी द इंक्रीज इन डिस्चार्ज एज वी कम्स इन डाउन स्ट्रीम पार्ट ऑफ द रिवर. नाउ दिस इज रिवर इंडस दैट इज कॉल्ड एज सिंधु. नाउ सिंधु वाटर्स और इंडस वाटर्स आर डिवाइडेड इन इंडिया एंड पाकिस्तान. नाउ दिस इज रिवर यमुना. दिस इज रिवर ब्रह्मपुत्रा. नाउ सी द डिस्चार्ज विच इज पासिंग. सी द विड्थ ऑफ दिस पर्टिकुलर चैनल इन फ्यू किलोमीटर्स से 3 किलोमीटर्स और इवन मोर व्हेन फ्लड्स आर देयर. सो दिस विल गिव यू द आइडिया अबाउट द क्वांटम ऑफ वाटर विच फ्लोज थ्रू रिवर ब्रह्मपुत्रा. नाउ दिस इज रिवर गोदावरी अनदर बिग रिवर. दिस इज रिवर गंगा एट पाटना. दिस इज रिवर गंगा एट पाटना. अगेन सी द डिस्चार्ज विच इज पासिंग एट पाटना. दिस इज रिवर सुवर्णरेखा. रिवर सुवर्णरेखा. अगेन यू सी द विड्थ ऑफ अ चैनल द डेप्थ ऑफ वाटर एंड क्वांटम ऑफ वाटर फ्लोइंग थ्रू रिवर सुवर्णरेखा. दिस इज रिवर महानदी इन ओरिसा. दिस इज रिवर महानदी इन ओरिसा. दिस इज रिवर नर्मदा एट ओमकारेश्वर. रिवर नर्मदा एट ओमकारेश्वर. दिस इज रिवर तापी एट सूरत. रिवर तापी एट सूरत. सो फॉर एवरी रिवर आई वॉट आई एक्सपेक्ट इज दैट यू जस्ट हैव द आइडिया ऑफ द डिस्चार्ज पासिंग थ्रू द रिवर, द विड्थ ऑफ द रिवर एंड क्वांटम ऑफ वाटर दैट इज अवेलेबल विद दीज रिवर्स. दिस इज रिवर साबरमती एट अहमदाबाद. So these works you observe, these are the works of the Sabarmati Riverfront Development Corporation, but you see the discharge passing through Sabarmati River. Now this is River Mahanadi. This is River Kaveri. So you will find that the watershed areas or the catchment areas of these southern rivers are small, that's why discharges are also limited and water resources potential is also limited. This is river Pennar. River Pennar. This is river Barak in Assam. River Barak in Assam. These are the major dams of India. And these are the salient features of these dams. It is Govind Sagar, Bhakra, Thin, Hirakud, Sardar Sarovar. The states in which these dams are located. This gives live storage in billion cubic meter. So this is Govind Sagar Bhakra Dam in Himachal Pradesh and it can have a live storage up to 6.23 BCM. It irrigates 676,000 hectares of agricultural land and 1,379 megawatt of electricity can be generated here. This is another picture of Bhakra Dam. The Thin Dam in Punjab. It has live storage of 2.34 BCM. It irrigates 348,000 hectares of agricultural land and hydropower generation of 600 megawatts. This is Hirakud Dam in Orissa with 5.38 as live storage, 153,000 hectares of irrigation and 307 megawatts of electricity it can generate. This is Sardar Sarovar Dam in Gujarat. With a live storage of 5076 BCM, irrigation of about 2120,000 hectares and hydroelectric capacity 1450 megawatt. This is Jayakwadi Dam in Maharashtra with live storage of 2.17 BCM and irrigating 227,000 hectares of agricultural land. This is Koyna Dam in Maharashtra with a storage of 2.65 BCM The water of Koyna is mainly used for hydropower of 1020 megawatt. This is Bhima, that is Uzuni Dam in Maharashtra, with capacity of 1.52 billion cubic meters, irrigation 125,000 hectares, and hydroelectricity 12 megawatts. This is Ramaganga Dam in Uttarakhand, with 2.20 BCM live storage, irrigation of 1,897,000 hectares, and hydropower capacity 198 megawatt. This is Tehri Dam from Uttarakhand, with 2.62 billion cubic meter live storage, 2,351,000 hectares of irrigation, and 1,000 megawatt of electricity it can generate. This is Gandhi Sagar Dam from Madhya Pradesh, with 6.83 billion cubic meter of live storage, irrigation capacity of 220,000 hectares, and hydroelectricity of 115 megawatt. This is Bansagar Dam from Madhya Pradesh, with live storage of 5.17 BCM, irrigation 488,000 hectares, and hydroelectricity 425 megawatt. This is Indira Sagar Dam of Madhya Pradesh, with live storage the highest in India, 9.75 billion cubic meter, irrigation 2,380,000 hectares, hydroelectricity 1,000 megawatt. This is Srishalem Dam from AP and Telangana, with a live storage of 8.29 BCM, irrigation 2,380,000 hectares, hydroelectric capacity 770 megawatt. This is Nagarjun Sagar Dam from AP and Telangana, with live storage of 5.11 BCM and irrigation 895,000 hectares and hydroelectricity 810 megawatt. This is Somasela Dam from Andhra Pradesh, with live storage of 1.99 billion cubic meter, irrigation of 168,000 hectares and no hydroelectricity. This is Idukki Dam from Kerala, with live storage of 1.46 BCM. It is not used for irrigation but used for hydropower of 780 megawatt. This is Prakasham Barrage from Andhra Pradesh across River Krishna. This is Mettur Dam from Tamil Nadu, with a live storage of 2.65 BCM, irrigation 122,000 hectares, hydroelectricity 360 megawatt. This is Almatti Dam across Krishna from Karnataka, with live storage 2.92 BCM, irrigation 213,000 hectares, hydroelectricity 297 megawatt. This is Tungabhadra Dam, Karnataka. And this total table gives you water resources potential of river basins of India. Let us have some questions. Question 1. Highest utilizable water in India is carried by so and so river. Answer is Ganga, about 250 billion cubic meter. Utilizable surface water resource of India is estimated as, these are the options. Answer is 690 billion cubic meter. Third question, the so and so dam holds highest live storage water in India. Answer is Indira Sagar, 9.25 billion cubic meter. So let us conclude. Average annual water resources potential of India is 1869.3 billion cubic meter. Average annual utilizable surface water potential of India is 690 billion cubic meter. Average annual groundwater availability in India is 452.2 billion cubic meter. North Indian rivers, including Ganga, Brahmaputra and Meghna, carry surplus water than their respective basin requirements, whereas South Indian rivers carry less water in comparison with North Indian rivers. So these are the references which are used for this presentation. Special thanks to Balchand Institute of Technology, Solapur, IDP in Education Technology, IIT Bombay. Thank you.